Alright. So, once they call it all, you're all boys, you're all shy. Boys, you're all talk with us. Double on us in your process of breaking the stone. And shall I want to all the action push this word in our
system? Come on, come
on. See, anyway, this is GMS Jamaica, right? We are the Hebrew Israelites from the group, as we said before, GMS, which is Great Stone. See, the chosen, right? Vessel where the Lord are gonna use, the Lord basically are used to build the house of David. See? We know you have men where outside of GMS where the Spirit of the Lord are working with them as well. Right? So we'll come out here for prophesy. To the elect of the nation of Israel. See? We hope that all things that we do, see, lead to the edification of the elect, right? The edification of everybody, right? Because the scripture says, do all things to edify. See, so whether you are part of the elect or not, see, something what we say, anything what we say, we try to make it edifying. See, now, we'll find this article, right? Because since we're coming at the truth, we hear a lot of doctrines, right? And one of those doctrines, are one of the most famous of those doctrines, is the law of attraction. See, which goes unparalleled with the scriptures. Just I'm gonna make the app read a few lines out tight, right? And we have to match it back. We're gonna see if it even match up with the scriptures.
Right. You say the law of attraction that comes. What is the law of attraction? Open your eyes to a world of endless possibilities. Simply put, the law of attraction is the ability to attract into our lives whatever we are focusing on. It is believed that regardless of age, nationality, or religious belief, we are all susceptible to the laws which govern the universe, including the law of attraction.
Right. Hey, a part of this saying is true. Right? We the scripture say we're born by the elements. See? So yes, we're susceptible, right, to the laws that govern the universe. Right? Because the Lord Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai set those laws in motion. See? However, the law of attraction is not a part of those laws. Right? Because if you are gonna speak of the law of attraction, then you are gonna bring free will into play. Yeah, which is confusion as the opposite. See? And every time somebody come up with the free will doctrine, see, which we will beat it down simple. We are evil.
Yo, ¿qué las cosas? ¿Cómo es con nuestra aviso?
I'm from Kingston. Yeah, I'm in the world. I'm in the world. I'm in the world. I'm in the world. I'm in the
world. So where are you going to that? Of Jeremiah 10 verse 23 says, O Lord, I know that the way of man is not in himself. It is not in man to walk, that walketh to direct his steps.
Right, so yeah, it is not in man that walketh to direct his steps. See, and according to the law of attraction, he said that anything where your mind see focus on, that is what you are going to achieve, that is what you are going to attract to yourself. But the scripture says otherwise.
Proverbs 16 verse 1, it says the preparation of the heart in man and the answer of the tongue is from the Lord.
Right, so the preparation of the mind, right, is from the Lord. Every thought that you think comes from the Lord. One.
It says all the ways of a man are clean in his own eyes, right. But the Lord Yahweh Bashami Yahushai weigh the spirit.
Right, the Lord weigh the spirit, yo. All the ways of a man clean in his own eyes. He feel like say, man feel like say, whatever them do, see that is the right way. Which contradict the whole law of attraction. Because as we said before, if you follow the law of attraction, it's going to free will. Which is madness and confusion.
Why all are we rich and everybody desires to be wealthy? Why are we not rich?
Yeah?
Why we not have life lasting forever? Seeing that if you think it, it's going to come into being. You think positive, it's going to happen. Which person do you think tell? You don't really want for them. Really want for them.
Yes. No. But when they're the people, they're the people.
Exactly. Yeah. Then, you have an answer, man?
Yeah, man. It is the law of attraction which uses the power of the mind to translate whatever is in our thoughts and materialize them into reality.
Right. See, man's mind don't have that kind of power. Because as the scripture said, whatever the mind think is the Lord, Yahweh Shai, the one who put that in there. See? And man think a whole heap of things, as we have said before. See? Man think about. See, man, not every man think about to get rich.
So the scripture says, all ways of man are clean in his own eyes, but the Lord with the spirit. Because as you say, man, he think a whole lot of things. And it's most I actually put thoughts in your mind. And if you think of, like, think of something new, when nobody has ever think about before. And make you see how well you get through with that. Yeah? Job 33 verse 14, it says, for the most I speak at once, yea, twice, yet man perceive it not.
Right.
In a dream, in a vision of the night when deep sleep falleth upon men, in slumberings upon the bed, then he openeth the ears of men and sealeth their instructions, that he may withdraw man from his purpose and hide pride from man.
Right. Seems that the Lord, set program you in the night while you sleep. See, the Lord Yahweh Hashem Yahushua set your steps where you're supposed to walk for the next day. See, and yet dumb niggas might ask for me to sleep for the next day. The Lord set that you don't sleep, brother. You see me?
You have a question?
No, not really. I'm just looking at
it.
I know that America's destruction is coming soon.
You know that America's
destruction
is coming soon?
Well,
yes. Can't you say yourself?
Because, I know that America will be falling. Not only will be falling, but because everything is going back to Europe.
Europe?
Yeah. Mm. Europe is going back, it's fighting for. I mean, this is going, the world is going back to the Orient, the Chinese. That is why America is actually fighting.
Listen,
for
it's going to go back to the Chinese?
Yes.
According to the scriptures?
Based on what Chinese going on with right now.
You believe in the Bible?
Most definitely.
Most definitely. Alright. Give me the scripture, we say For Jacob is the end of the world. And Esau is the end of the world.
Where is that?
See, because a lot of even Chinese them feel like say they're gonna be in the next ruling power. In truth and in fact, China, you see all them big investment that's them do over the world? China of themselves now do that is the so-called white man. I use the UN for do all them things the rest of you get done. That's, you know, this China, Chinese people are some hardcore slave labor, make them economy grow.
Right.
See? Which shows that them not upon them own power. The British conquer China. If you watch certain kung fu movies, you see where certain black characters go down there, go fight against the Chinese them, because the Chinese them is the same fight for them freedom. You understand me, I say? No, the elite already control the Bank of Hong Kong, which is the central bank of China. Now, anybody control your money, and them actually control you, because your money is what keeps you afloat as a nation. Yeah? So the so-called white race, these men, the elites, they are the ones that control China by using the United Nations. Yeah? But the Chinese won't be the next superpower, none at all.
Who will be the next superpower?
Israelites, the 12 tribes of the nation of Israel, our people. Yeah? And it is according to prophecy. Bring it up, our question.
Second Esdras 6 and verse 7. Mm-hmm. Then answered I and said, what shall be the parting asunder of the times?
Mm-hmm. How you going to know? Meaning, how you going to know the times between the rulership of the so-called white man, yeah, and our rulership as the Israelites, the so-called African-American, the so-called Negroes, yeah? What will be the rulership of our time? Yeah, go ahead.
Or when shall be the end of the first, mm-hmm, and the beginning of it that followeth?
Yeah. And what is going to be the end of the first rulership? And the beginning, of that rulership we're in now, what will be the beginning of it that followeth? So you said to them all that this one is going down, which is true. So what's going to be the beginning of it that followeth? And I'm going to explain to you now. Go ahead.
Verse 8. Huh? And he said unto me, from Abraham unto Isaac, mm-hmm, when Jacob and Esau were born.
No, Esau, the descendants of Esau, are the so-called white people. They are known as the so-called Caucasians. They are known as the Edomites, yeah? The descendants of Esau. So he might show you from Mark the time.
That means Jacob, Esau, that's Jacob's brother, right?
Brother, yeah. And Jacob get the 12 tribes of the nation of Israel. See them here? Yeah, the so-called Puerto Ricans, the so-called Black American, the so-called
Jacob
American.
Jacob had all of those?
Yes.
When he was, when he wrestled with the angel, right?
After that, when his name changed, yeah. and him have Leah and Rachel, and Leah and Rachel's servants, eh? And him get them pregnant and get...
Yeah, man, tomorrow you get that, you know? You know, worry yourself about that.